On Saturday, volunteer searchers found the body of 29-year-old Carie Munoz Hufford less than a mile from her home. This is video of the area where the body was found. As you can see, it is covered with dense brush. Firefighters even needed a chainsaw to cut through the thick brush just to get to the body. Action News reporter Mei Chow is live in our St. Louis newsroom with the latest.
Aaron, it was indeed a tragic turn of events for family members who were looking for Carie Munoz Hufford at the same time volunteer searchers discovered the body of the young mother.
On Monday, two candles were placed alongside Imjin Parkway, just feet from where searchers found the body of 29-year-old Marina resident Carie Munoz Hufford. Carie, who also went by Lulu, was last seen by her husband on the morning of January 17th. On Saturday, she was found dead in a thick brush off a well-traveled walking trail bordering the west side of Imjin Parkway, north of Abrams Drive. David Hufford told Action News on the day Carie was last seen, she told him she wasn't feeling well because she had the flu. He came home from an appointment to find Carrie's cell phone and purse in their house on Carpenter Court, but no signs of Carie. Her sisters, Jolie Munoz and Katie Solas, never gave up hope on their baby sister and had even searched for Carie on their own. Other than David Hufford, the only other known person who saw Carie that Friday was a woman who called Marina police to say she saw someone matching Carrie's description walking barefoot in the area of Imjin and Abrams Drive. At this point, police don't suspect foul play and say her death appears to be accidental. Investigators believe she was walking along a path that's popular with joggers and bikers, but somehow wandered off into an area filled with thick vegetation.
And at this hour, Marina police have not yet released the cause of death. Investigators still waiting for toxicology results and an autopsy report. Aaron.
Thank you, May. More than 100 people turned out for the search on Saturday. Monterey Peninsula Violent Crime and Narcotics Team, the County Coroner Division, and Marina Police all investigated the discovery of the body.